and another hadith that we want to speak with you about today is that of the hadith of the Messenger of Allah والسلام, again, when he addressed the issue of lying. Now again, all of this is tied into the issue of April Fool's Day. This is where we're trying to get an understanding of how we understand the way that we look as Muslims at the origin of this day, this particular day, let alone partaking in it. There's a hadith that was narrated on the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam, where he was reported as saying, وَيْلٌ لِلَّذِي يُحَدِّثْ فَيَكْذِبْ لِيُضْهِكَ بِهِ النَّاسِ وَيْلٌ لَهُ وَيْلٌ لَهُ. Now, try and understand the importance of staying away from lying, especially on days when they're telling you the thing to do is to lie. Look at how the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam, he says in this hadith, woe to the one who speaks and he lies, and so he lies to make the people laugh. He says, waylun lahu. He says, woe to him, woe to him. This is a serious situation. Forget what has become a custom in many of our societies. Now we have a day in which it's the custom to lie. It's the thing to do. And at the same point in time, as Muslims in these societies, we understand that the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam told us to stay away from doing this. He advised, not only did he advise us, but he warned us from doing it. He said three times in this hadith, woe to this individual, woe to this individual, woe to this individual. So think long and hard before you sit around with your friends and family and start trying to lie and then turn around and say, I gotcha, ha ha ha. Because this isn't who we're supposed to be as Muslims, let alone what we're supposed to be about.